Create your world. Create your world.
By a young teacher that was teaching in elementary school, and his wife was giving birth to his first child. And he said to the Board of Education, that's what it was called back then, I want to take a paternity leave. And they said, are you nuts? Now this is 1969. They said, you're nuts. Well, this teacher had the guts to say, well, I'm going to sue you. And he sued the Board of Ed. His name is Gary Ackerman. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Gary then decided, obviously, to leave teaching during his paternity leave and started what was called the Flushing Tribune on Casino Boulevard in Flushing. And the paper, the first issue of the paper, was 8 pages. And it was a bi-weekly. And from there, we became a public company years ago. The public company owned 26 newspapers in New York and Washington, D.C. The Hill newspaper in D.C. we started. We owned Dan's papers at the time, and we owned other papers in every borough of Queens, including Long Island. And years later, we took the company private, a group of us did, Gary Ackerman, myself, and my predecessor, Michael Schenkler, and we decided to buy a paper in Huntington. It is one of the oldest papers in the United States, started by a young kid in 1838 named Walt Whitman. That paper is called the Long Islander. And we then sold it a number of years ago to somebody out there in Huntington. And that paper is thriving like we are here. But the Queens Tribune covers Queens. But I'm going to make an apology. We don't all cover the neighborhoods of Queens the way we should. And this year, since Michael retired a couple of years ago and I took it over, I decided that we had to do some things different. One is ramp up the other paper that we had, the Press of Southeast Queens, that covers the community south of Hillside Avenue. It goes down to the airport and out to the Nassau border. And we wanted to make that a paper that recognizes that community very well. And it has for the last 15 years, and it's grown tremendously. But there is still a hole in our corporate structure and the way we look at things. Part of it is language, part of it is relationships. We have some, we don't have enough. So this year I decided with our people to put something to this together.
Shani? I'm going to say, soy Melinda Katz, soy presidente de Condado de Queens. Eso es todos, that's it. That's all I got. Let's hear it for Michael Nussbaum and the great work that he has done. And Michael, I feel like I'm of that age, because that's, you know, another 50th birthday, right? So I feel like I'm of the age where I can say, you have done a great job for the people of this borough for generations, and we thank you for all of that work. Queens Tribune and the Press of Southeast Queens, to all the reporters and the editors and all the folks that make the paper come out every week on a Thursday, for all of you that instantaneously blog everything that we're doing before we leave the room at the Queens Tribune. You really do a service to this great borough in making sure that the information that needs to get out there is read, making it interesting, bringing out the facts, the editorials that are so well written. And we thank you for the service that you've given. The Latino population has been such an extraordinary, extraordinary partner with the growth of this borough. And so on behalf of the 2.3 million people I represent, I would love to thank, please, our great speaker, Melissa Mark Viverito, who I had the honor of serving with. And
great day today. We began this morning with some of the other colleagues from the city council who invested some money so that we can have a brand new tech incubator on campus that will help out young entrepreneurs here in the southeastern part of Queens to begin their businesses and connect with our students. Anybody who has heard me before knows that I brag that we have the largest computer science number of majors of any school in New York City. So I share that because one of the things that's been a blessing in my life is that I've been able to serve, and I've been able to serve in places that are special and that are wonderful. I have the honor now of being here at Queens. It's been a phenomenal, transformative institution in the borough. It has touched the lives of many of you here and many more. I was before at Hostos, and I want to thank my colleagues from Hostos for being here with me today. And the guys from Queens have no choice. The folks from Hostos did have a choice, and they came. So I want to thank them. For doing that, but it's really been a privilege to be in a number of positions, situations where you're able to serve, and you're able to serve with an incredible team, the team here at Queens, the faculty, the staff, the real president of Queens College, Jap, president of Student Association, say hi, Jap. Say hi, yes. A big partner. They allow you to do your work. Because the college and because the borough is such a phenomenally diverse space in both cases, I have seldom talked about the fact that I am the first Latino ever to be president of Queens College, right? It's something and being the first is always an honor, but precisely because of the diversity here, right? If you're going to pay homage to the diversity of the college, you have to have a rotating presidency in which you will have a Latino for a week, and then you have somebody who's Chinese the next week, and an Indian person the following week, and then somebody from Korea, somebody from Colombia, somebody who's Irish, somebody, because that is our college, that is our borough, and that is incredibly, incredibly beautiful. And for me, all that it says is that is one of the driving forces that has characterized the college, and I take that very seriously, and I try to connect with whatever that experience is from the students that we have here and from the incredible diverse faculty and staff that you have.
For the first time, that was 1980, we had a mayor of the city of New York meeting with the Latino community of Queens. We had over 800 people, and he was so impressed. And since there, the governor decided to have an office for Hispanic Affairs, and the mayor has his office for Hispanic Affairs, and we got connected with all the elected officials. Claire Schulman, excellent supporter of the center, and we have been working since then. At that time, we didn't have a single judge, nobody in the judiciary. So we fought very hard to get Jaime Rios, the first Latino elected to the judiciary. He became the first judge, and we continued working. It wasn't just me, it was a bunch of very energetic and committed people. We elected then the judge to Supreme Court. Now we have three women in Supreme Court, three Latinas too? Okay, well. We have Tizia Pineda Kerwin, and we have Carmen Velasquez. And it has been a very hard work because nobody gives you anything. You have to earn it.
por ti sigo loquita, porque insistes en mentir. Si tú eres quien me necesita, sabes que yo estoy libre y disfrutando. No te estoy buscando. Podría decirte que ya no queda nada, no queda casi nada. Lo que yo fui contigo se perdió en el olvido. No, no queda nada, no queda casi nada. Lo que viví contigo se perdió en el olvido. No, no, oh, 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 oh. Lo nuestro ya pasó. Oh, 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 oh. Ya no estarás conmigo. Oh, 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 oh. Esto se terminó. Oh, 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 oh. No quiero más contigo.
Eso que tú me llamabas amor, esa manera de ver la relación no me funcionó. No te cuento que yo, cuando me fui empezó la locura, felicidad en vez de amargura. En cambio tú, mala actitud. Nunca volví pa' sorpresa tuya. Lo que te duele es que ahora te huya. Si eres tú, podría decirte que ya no queda nada.
I thank you, universe, for all the goodness you're bringing my way. I receive it, I accept it, and I thank you for it, and so it is.
Month is the only month that actually is not a month, it's actually 2 months. It goes from September 15th to October 15th, and supposedly there were a number of countries that achieved independence during that period of time, and that's why we celebrate that month. But, you know, I'm so proud to be here to participate, and we're looking forward to our outstanding speaker, Melissa Mark Viverito, who really makes us all proud. Thank you very much.
And because of that, I know that I have a lot to give forward, because a lot was given to me. The strong foundation that was given to me, I have to give it forward. So when I became president, I first was president of the Latino Lawyers Association of Queens County back in 2004 through 2006. And when I was president of the Latino Lawyers in Queens, I started a project with someone else, Jose Perez, called Street Law in Español Program, which basically we used to team up as lawyers with students at St. John's Law School, and we started giving workshops and programs in the community. So the very first place that I went to was Our Lady of Sorrows, because that was my church growing up in Corona, Queens. So we went there, we gave a presentation. We had over 150 people that came to church that morning to hear us, to give them advice on either landlord-tenant rights, labor rights, and things of that nature. When I became president of the Queens County Women's Bar Association last year, I was, as they stated, the first Latina, but I was the first Latina president in 84 years in Queens County. Again, I found it important to give something or teach something Hispanic to that organization. So I coordinated with some other members of my group a trip to Cuba. So we went in May of this year to Cuba. It was 19 of us, and they got to see, we got to do an interchange with the other lawyers and judges from Cuba as well. It was an amazing trip. And you know, now I'm treasurer of the State Women's Bar Association of the state of New York. Again, another first Latina in that organization to serve as an officer. But I have a lot to do. I feel like I have a lot of work to do. He explained, Mike gave a little history about the work that I've done, but you know, what's next for Lourdes? I want to be a judge. I want to be a judge here.
I was struck by what Lourdes says, and I believe she will make a great judge, not when, but it's going to be if, because it's going to happen very soon, I'm sure. My father's first cousin was a woman named Sadie Turek, and she is a legendary figure in the Queens Women's Bar. She has passed on now. She lived to be 102. Her mother lived to be 106. She was Danny Drum's constituent. I think she voted for you. That's what she told me, Danny.
Smart lady.
But she was a very, very smart lady. And even at 100, I am channeling the Who. It's not me. Anyway, so there are a lot of people who have made great progress in this county. And I'm happy to be a part of the political firmament. I came here tonight to honor your honorees, especially our speaker, who has really, in a short time, done a lot to democratize the city council, and really has stood up for a democracy with a small and large D in this city. And I'm very proud to be one of the people that works with her each and every day. I said to
thank you very much. Hola, buenas noches. Hi, good evening. Me llamo Ángel Gil. My name is Ángel Gil, or as the Americans say, Angel Gil. I'm the artistic executive director of the Thalia Spanish Theater, soy el director artístico ejecutivo del Teatro Thalia. On behalf of the board of directors of the Thalia Spanish Theater, we would like to thank the Queens Tribune for this honor. And we will like also to thank the City Council, Melissa Mark Viverito, Julissa Ferreras, our councilman Jimmy Van Bramer, especially because of their support, and all the City Council, because definitely they are helping us for us to be able to do what we do, and of course Queens Borough President Melinda Katz, who really have been very helpful in all the what we've been doing. And as it was said, yes, definitely, we've been in existence for 39 years now, and we are the only bilingual Hispanic theater in Queens, and would like to become in our next stage to be the Thalia Hispanic Arts Center. So therefore, to be able to serve better all the culture and arts of the Hispanics, and not only in Queens, in the whole city of New York, and of course, especially the Hispanics, but all the communities. So I would like to thank also.
And obviously, every immigrant has its story. And my story began with my brave parents who fled Cuba to the United States. To provide my brother and I with freedom and opportunity that we didn't have there. And we, my family, were the lucky ones. So the four of us came here, and obviously we didn't have much. So we came with a few pairs of clothes, and that was it. As my mother got on the plane, she had to give up her wedding band because they said, take it off or you don't get on the plane. So I have to say to you that it wasn't easy back then. It really wasn't. I remember it wasn't, New York was not bilingual friendly. It was not. You know, my first day of kindergarten, I was there was nobody else that spoke Spanish. It was me, and I just smiled because I had a new dress on, and that was a big thing in my household. So I had a new dress, I had a little plastic suitcase, so it was great. So that inspired me to be smiling, even though I had no idea what was going on. Seeing that. So anyway, as I look to the future, you know, I think I want to share with you that my life long journey is to really leave this world a better place. And that's by creating value, by helping other people achieve their greatness, and also by inspiring other Hispanics that education, hard work, and passion are the ingredients to success. So thank you again for this great honor. I'm going to dedicate my award to my father, who's in heaven. I hope he's smiling.
Danny, if you'd like to say a few words. I know the speaker's coming.
Well, thank you, Mike. Muchísimas gracias, Mike. Es un gran placer para mí estar aquí con todos de ustedes para celebrar este mes de la herencia hispana. Aquí en el condado de Queens, y porque yo soy el representante de Jackson Heights y Elmhurst en el Consejo Municipal, es importante que nosotros tenemos un representante que puede hablar español, ¿verdad? Y porque este es un evento en honor de los latinos, también es importante que nosotros hablamos español aquí, lo mismo. So it's a great pleasure to be here, and I think that for those of you who don't speak Spanish, I said it's great to be a representative for Jackson Heights and Elmhurst, and to have the ability to be able to speak Spanish, and to be able to speak with my constituents in Spanish as well. I learned Spanish in high school. I fell in love with all Spanish things, Latino things, Hispanic things, learned about all the different countries, traveled to Spain, in 1971, cuando Franco fue el líder de España, and you know, I was really immersed in Spanish and continued Spanish. But where I really learned Spanish is when I came back from college, and then I was working at PS 199Q as a teacher, and the kids in the school, they taught me Spanish. I was able to do my parent-teacher conferences with the parents in Spanish, and that drew them into into the parent-teacher conferences. But I say that as background, because you know, my family comes from Ireland. And in Ireland, when Cromwell took over Ireland in the 1600s, he forbade us from speaking our own language. And he imposed English on the Irish. And for about 400 years, it was forbidden to speak Irish in Ireland. Can you imagine, in our own country? And it was only with the 1916 revolution, when we gained independence from England, that we said in Ireland that we were going to go back to teaching our language in our schools in Ireland. And I take that lesson and try to share that lesson with people, because I think it's really important, especially if I may, for us as Latinos, if I may say that, because I think tonight we are all Latinos, that we never forget where we have come from, and we never forget our language, and that we teach our children our language, and that we make sure the rest of the nation knows that language and respects that language.
So first of all, just thank you for this recognition. I really appreciate the role of the press in our city is important, and of our local neighborhood papers even more so in terms of getting the word out. You build a bond with the Queens residents, with your neighbors here. So you're helpful to us in really being able to communicate the agenda that we're setting forth and some of the things that Danny outlined. You know, to Barry and to Danny, you know, thank you for your collegiality, for your friendship, and making our city council as effective as it can. To all the honorees, congratulations. To Felo, the president. I have a long relationship with Felo, and he knew my mother when they worked in government in Puerto Rico as well, so we have a long-standing relationship. But, you know, I'm very proud, particularly that this is being given to me during Hispanic Heritage Month, because my culture and my identity as a Puerto Ricana, it means everything to me. I would not be who I am if I really wasn't clear about who I am, right? And being proud of my history, my culture, has given me direction and given me guidance. And you know, growing up in a household of activists, my mother was active in the feminist movement in Puerto Rico. I was born and raised on the island until the age of 18. So not only was I raised by her, but I was raised by all those other women in the movement. That really let me know that as a woman, you have a place, you have a voice, and you're going to be heard. And my father was very, very active in his own way as well. But these events are important as a way of validating the contributions of our community. And I appreciate it. It means a lot to me. And I know that also, you know, to some extent, I've been a pioneer. And broken several barriers as being the first Puerto Rican woman to represent East Harlem, which is the cradle of the Puerto Rican community. I was the first woman, the first Puerto Rican to be elected into that position, to now be first Latina, the first person of color, right? A member of the Black Latino Asian Caucus to serve as Speaker of the City Council. I know I've broken barriers, and that gives a lot of inspiration to others who tell me each and every day that they're glad that I'm giving them a voice. So this means a lot to me. I appreciate it. I look forward to the ongoing partnership and to each and every one of you that is contributing to build this wonderful city that we live in. Thank you for that as well. So enjoy your evening. Muchas gracias.
Sé que te gusta decir que yo por ti sigo loquita, porque insistes en mentir. Si tú eres quien me necesita, sabes que yo estoy libre y disfrutando. No te estoy buscando. Podría decirte que ya no queda nada, no queda casi nada. Lo que yo fui contigo se perdió en el olvido. No, no queda nada, no queda casi nada. Lo que viví contigo se perdió en el olvido. No, no, oh, 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 oh. Lo nuestro ya pasó. Oh, 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 oh. Ya no estarás conmigo. Oh, 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 oh. Esto se terminó. Oh, 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 oh. No quiero más contigo. Eso que tú me llamabas amor, esa manera de ver la relación no me funcionó. No, te cuento que yo cuando me fui empezó la locura. Felicidad en vez de amargura. En cambio tú, mala actitud. Nunca volví pa' sorpresa tuya. Lo que te duele es que ahora te huya. Si eres tú, podría decirte que ya no queda nada.
On the drums.